Good morning children, welcome to the second session of soil. Before starting today's session, we will recap the last session. So what is soil children? It is a thin layer on the earth surface where plants can grow. And it is a precious resource as it has taken millions of years for its formation. Later we have discussed the importance of soil, like it provides nutrients for the growth of the plants. It acts as a water filter. It provides shelter for many tiny living things like earthworms, moles, bacteria and fungi. What are bacteria and fungi? They are microorganisms. Even medicines such as penicillin are prepared from bacteria and fungi that grow in soil. And later we have even watched a video regarding the formation of soil. I hope you all enjoyed that. So, shall we start today's session? Come on. Today's new words. Composition. C-O-M-P-O-S-I-T-I-O-N. Composition. Next word. Gravel. G-R-A-V-E-L. Gravel. Silt. S-I-L-T. Silt. Humus. H-U. M-U-S, humus. Next word, loam. L-O-A-M, loam. The last word, clayey. C-L-A-Y-E-Y, clayey. Composition of soil. Children, what do you mean by composition? It means the substances which are present in soil. Here we will make a watch for the substances which are present in the soil. They include gravel, sand, silt, clay, humus, air, water. These are the substances which are present in soil. Here we will know more about the substances which are present in soil. Gravel. The small stones which are present in soil. Children, I have even placed the picture so that you can understand very easily. Sand. The sand particles are the largest soil particles and they have large spaces in between so that air enters in, and if you have any water, the water will be drained very easily because of these large air spaces. Silt. Silt particles are smaller than sand particles. This silt holds water as well as some nutrients for plants to grow. Clay. Clay particles are the smallest soil particles. They hold water for a long time and they even have small spaces in between. Humus. Humus is made up of rotting remains of plants and animals. Children, when plants and animals die, they are acted upon by bacteria and fungi which are present in the soil. When they act upon these dead plants and animals, they become rot and they add nutrients to the soil. So plants use these nutrients for their growth. How we are having the nutrients? We are taking food rich in nutrients. And how the plants are having the nutrients? They are using these nutrients from humus. Air. Air fills the spaces between soil particles. We find air even in the soil so that the roots of plants can breathe. Water. Soil even contains water that is used by the plants for their need. We have learned the composition of soil. Now we will have a look on the types of soil. There are three basic kinds of soil. They are sandy soil, clayey soil and loam. Children, most of the soils are made up of sand, silt and even clay. The color as well as the quality of a soil depends on how much silt, sand and clay are mixed in it. So the best soil for plant growth is the one which has all the three types of particles in the right mix. Sandy soil. The name itself tells us that it has a lot of sand with very little silt and clay. Have you seen the color, children? The color is grayish brown in color. Sandy soil particles have large spaces in between so that they can hold a lot of air but not water for long. So it is not good for growing crops. Clay soil. Clay soil has a lot of clay with little silt and sand. Have you seen the color, children? It is like brown in color. The soil particles of this soil has little space to hold water and not much air. So even this is not good for growing crops. The third type of soil is loam. Children, we have discussed that the best soil for plant growth is the one which has sand, silt and clay in equal proportions. So loam is the soil which has the right mix of sand, silt and clay. So it holds air as well as water. It even contains humus. How is humus made? It is made up of rotting remains of plants and animals. So the plants get all the nutrients from the humus. That is the reason farmers and gardeners choose loam soil to grow crops and plants.
Depending upon the type and the amount of particles present in the soil, it is of three types: sandy soil, clayey soil, and loamy soil. Sandy soil is grayish brown in color. It has large particles which allow air and water to pass through it. This soil cannot hold water. Sandy soil is found on the beaches and river banks. Clay soil is brown in color. It has very fine particles which stick together. It can hold a lot of water. Plants like rice that need lot of water grow well in this soil. Clay soil is found near the river mouths. Loamy soil is a mixture of sand, clay and lot of humus. This soil retains some water and lets the extra water pass through completely. It is the best soil for the growth of plants. Loamy soil is found in plains and plateaus. Activity 1. Take three pots with holes at the bottom. Place each of them on two bricks. Take three small pieces of cotton cloth and spread them at the bottom of each pot. The holes at the bottom of pots should be completely covered. Take equal amount of sandy, clayey and loamy soils and put them in pots separately. Keep a small beaker under the hole of each pot as shown. Now pour equal amount of water in each pot. Note the amount of water collected in each beaker. Note which soil has maximum water holding capacity. You will find that clay soil can hold maximum water as very little water is collected in the beaker. Sandy soil holds minimum water as much water is collected in the beaker.
Today's key points. Soil is composed of the following substances: gravel, very small stones in soil; sand, largest soil particles; silt, smaller than sand particles; clay, smallest soil particles; humus, made up of rotting remains of plants and animals; air, which fills the spaces between soil particles; water, soil also contains water that is used by plants. We have three basic kinds of soil. They are sandy soil, clayey soil, and loam. Sandy soil has a lot of sand and very little silt and clay. This soil has large spaces to hold a lot of air but not water for a long time. Clayey soil has a lot of clay with little silt and sand. This soil has little space to hold water for long but not much air. Loam, it has the right mix of sand, silt and clay. It can hold air and water as well. This soil contains humus. So farmers and gardeners choose loam to grow crops and plants.